one option for mushroom cultivation is forest grown mushrooms, which there's about four different species that we can grow successfully in the woods. Most mushrooms in the United States right now are grown indoors on usually on beds of composted manure or sawdust, and so we're looking for ways to utilize the forest and think about forest health as one of our objectives while we're growing a really delicious and medicinal food product as well. And so the four species you can grow are shiitake, lion's mane, oyster, and Stropharia, or otherwise known as the red wine cap mushroom. And so three of those species grow on logs, and we'll look at different ways to do that. And the fourth grows on a bed of wood chips. With your choice of totem inoculation, you can go with kind of oyster or lion's mane. And the oyster, there's several different species. There's lots of different colors you can play with. Generally, we found that the gray oysters and the golden oysters are the ones that produce best. And that's really no different physiologically other than color in terms of the spawn. It looks all kind of like white sawdust. And so those can be inoculated anytime. And oyster is a native mushroom that's found a lot in the northeast woods, pretty common on poplar and those softer woods. And you can try the other ones, the blue ones, the pink ones, the different colors, but we found most of our luck with the gray, the white, and the golden. With lion's mane, the spawn comes, there's two different types of lion's mane. There's a Hericium americanum, and then there's Hericium arenaceus. And we sometimes call the arenaceus the pom-pom ball. Americanum's like a coral mushroom because the americanum is much more corally looking in the way it grows. And the arenaceus looks very much like a big ball with these teeth hanging off. They're very beautiful mushrooms. Tastes very much like seafood, like lobster or scallops or something when they're cooked. And they're very medicinal as well. There's lots of research around their link to memory and sort of mental health. So either one of those is a good choice for your totems. So research at Cornell has mostly looked at lion's mane cultivation and found that both the lion's mane tend to fruit in the fall, although we see that occasionally some will fruit in the spring. And so by selecting both strains, you can actually increase your chances of getting different mushrooms at different times of the year. But we don't see the same kind of stratification or like even spread throughout the season as we have with shiitake. And that's probably just an issue of breeding, that if we were actually to spend more time, there's about three or four strains of lion's mane available on the market today. So a very small amount versus shiitake has maybe 20 or 30 strains. And so it's probably just a limitation of that. But really any of them are going to have good success. It's just that some might fruit more often or in the spring versus the fall. The oysters tend to be very consistent. What we've seen more anecdotally than research is that we have oysters fruiting anywhere from June to October, pretty widespread of the season. Again, not predictably, just sort of when they want to, more or less. And that the best species we found really to work on the logs is the golden oyster. On poplar logs seems to be the most productive. But we haven't done research, we've just been experimenting sort of anecdotally with that.